Summertime, and the Japanese beetles are invading. We're going to look at how to control them, yes, but also, are they an invasive or are they an indicator of? How do you identify them? How do you know that it's actually a Japanese beetle? Well, there are really not that many that we have that are green with a bronze or brass colored back. It's a beetle, not a mosquito, not a fly. It's a beetle with the two covers on its wings. And hey, if you're not sure, just look up Japanese beetle. Japanese beetle. Ah, yeah, the name gives it away. Where they're originally from is from Japan. But they've since not been introduced purposefully. They've since been introduced into North America and Europe. And that's where they're really spreading. That's where people are disturbed by them, mainly because they're not from here. So they didn't come with all their predators and their control agents. Are they invasive? Well, invading as in they weren't here before, they are here now, and they're spreading and expanding. So in areas like in North America and Europe, where perhaps 25 years ago you didn't even have them, now you have them. Yes, in that case, they would be invading a new area. Correct. Call them invasive. Japanese beetles' life cycle begins, let's start it with adults. They, at the time when they emerge and they're adult beetles, all they do is eat, mate, and lay eggs. After they lay the eggs in or near the soil, the larvae, or little larvae, the little beetle to come, hatch, go into the soil, and spend usually a year, but in really the coldest parts of their range, they can spend 2 years until they grow large enough. And they are a grub. That's most of the time you'll see them as a C-shaped grub. After they spent their time and when the soil temperature is right and they've grown, and by the way, they do eat roots, especially of grasses. So if you ever have an eaten out area, it's one of the grubs, but it could be Japanese beetle. They do cause quite a bit of damage on certain grassy areas. When they reach their time and the temperature is right, the soil temperature, then they pupate and finally emerge as an adult, usually June to August, depending on the area. And they'll live only for 30 to 45 days as adults. But in that time, the female will lay, about that, 30 to 45 eggs. And the cycle starts again. So which stage are you seeing them at? I bet it's the adult phase. What plants do Japanese beetle really go after? Thankfully, they don't really like apples, but in our area, they really like grapes. They'll also be sometimes on pear trees, plum, cherry. They can also go for strawberry, raspberry. There's a host of plants that they can eat the leaves. And your area can be different from another. If you stay to the end, I'll tell you what they're an indicator of, and the plants are a good clue. What soils that they prefer? Really, it's the function of the plants that they want. And even in this sandy soil, yes, you'll find them, but it's a whole range of soil types where you'll find Japanese beetle. How do you control Japanese beetles? Please, no synthetic pesticides, because you think, well, we'll put this on, we'll get rid of them. No pesticide is specific to one insect. Even though their picture is on the cover of the container, it will kill a whole range of insects and very likely will be killing their predators as well. So keep away from the synthetic pesticides, please. Another simple enough way to control them is you can hand trap them. Just taking them and shaking them into a container or a bucket of soapy water, and they'll drown pretty quickly. That's one way, hand pick. You can spray kaolin clay to, they just don't like walking on it, so it can discourage them from going into the plant you like. Another way to control them is just to net your plant that you really want to protect. If you just have a few plants, you can net. We don't net, but you can net. And one way that's really, you'll see the most often as a way to control them, is to trap them. This is a trap for codling moth, for apple trees. But there are traps for Japanese beetle, specifically for Japanese beetle. And one way that traps, whether this one or Japanese beetle trap, all the traps work on scent. So in these cases, it's a molasses and water scent that the codling moth are attracted to by smelling it. The wind is coming from there. It carries that, so I can smell it. And it'll go downwind, and if that insect is downwind, it zooms in, it kind of zigzags in to find the trap or the essence. For Japanese beetles, a lot of times you'll add a pheromone. Pheromone is the sex odor of a male or a female to, usually it's the female, to attract the males in. And so it's the signal, hey, here I am, come get me. So the males will come flying in and you trap them in that way. So pheromones work really well. The only thing is, you won't just catch the ones locally right around the trap, especially downwind of it. You'll also carry it. And in some cases, these traps can be effective for a range of several hundred meters or several hundred yards. So you will attract all the Japanese beetles from a distance coming. And research studies have shown that, you know what? It may not be a great idea if you have just a yard to put in one or two or more traps, because you'll attract a whole bunch and you don't get them all in the trap. At best, they're about 75% of the Japanese beetles will be caught in the trap. So you're actually importing from outside your yard, and you can have too many. So that is the danger of trapping, is that, yeah, do you really want to attract them? If you have chickens, trap them, catch them, bag them, freeze them, give them fresh to your chickens if you have some. That's a great way to make use of a problem being a solution. I've been here long enough to have seen the invasion process happen in our area. How does it normally happen? Well, you start to see a few, then you start to see a lot more, and then you have an on-right invasion. And that's what happened in every area where they newly arrived. But I've also seen them long enough around to know what tended to happen was, it was far worse about 4 or 5 years ago. And I've noticed that you kind of have a peak for 5 years. There's just a huge number of them. And they're eating and skeletonizing, which is really what they do to leaves. They eat everything except the veins. So there were times that a lot of plants, especially grapes here, looked completely skeletonized. And so for 5 years, if you can get over the hump, it gets better. Mainly because predators move in. Predators, I said they're invasive, they're not native to our range. In Japan, they're not really a problem because there's a whole host of predators that have had a long time to make use of them as a resource. Here, it's not been the case, at least not in the beginning. The last few years, we've been noticing more and more, there's two main predators have been introduced as a biocontrol, so that's an insect parasitizing or eating or killing the pest, in this case, Japanese beetle. So if you see on their thorax or on the hard shell, the green shell, if you see spots, it's a little white spot, that's a fly that's gonna lay an egg on it. The egg burrows into their cavity, eats them from the inside out, and then emerges, just like in the horror stories. So those two predators, one acting on the grub and one acting on the adults, have really helped slowly reduce their number. The other thing is, there's not just insects as predators. There are birds. I said chickens. You can feed them to chickens because chickens will eat them. But birds don't just go, oh, look, it's moving, I'll eat it. No, they tend to eat what they've been fed. So for the first 5 years, I've noticed that there was really no natural or native birds that were making use of them as food. It takes a while for the birds to learn that these are food items because they tend to eat what they were fed when they were in the nest. So thankfully, lately, in the last few years, birds are starting to bring beetles to the nest, feed the young. Those young, when they return next year, or even that year as they emerge or as they fledge, they'll start eating them. And there's a range of birds that have been found to eat Japanese beetles. And that will just increase as birds go, hey, you know, there's a whole lot of this food, let's make use of it. So add some nest boxes, attract more birds, and they will help. They won't eliminate them. They'll never eliminate anything that's a food item, but they will bring their populations down. And that's really what you want. The future for Japanese beetles, they will continue to expand their range. They'll become established. They'll be just one of the insects in that range. But their predators will follow them. And I say follow because they're not on the leading edge. Usually the predators lag behind. But the predators being the insects, maybe there'll be more brought in, and the birds will continue to make use of them so that in the future they probably won't be quite the same pest as they are now. The combination of soil, the plants that are growing, the stage of the invasion process, and really they indicate how severe of a monoculture you have. Try diversifying, try adding more plants so that one plant is hit, maybe one species is hit, and it won't affect all your plants, which happens when you have a monoculture. Japanese beetles are indicators. Do we ask why? Why do we have Japanese beetles? Yes, they've invaded, I get that. And let's put that aside. But now looking, you have them. They're on your plants, they're in your yard. Why? Are they on all your plants? Will you say, no, they have only certain preferred plants. Correct. But let's say plum tree. Are they on all your plum trees? Are they on all the plum trees in the neighborhood? Is there a plum tree that's not hit? Is there a cultivar that they're really not on that one? That's getting closer to the why. Why are all the plum trees hit, but there is some that aren't hit? You want to be able to look and say, you know what? Yes, most of them, but not this one, not that one, not the other one. Huh, why is that? I love Sir Albert Howard's statement where he said the pest, the insect pest, the disease pest, and even the weed are not the problem. They are pointing us to the actual root of the problem. For Japanese beetle, they are on John Kemp's plant health pyramid. They are a stage 4, which is the last stage or the last group of insects that your plant can get rid of. They're not the ones that are, they're not in the low range like aphids, which are quite easy to have on your plants. But there, it means your plant is already doing well enough that it's not bothered by a whole range, but it's bothered by beetles. And if you can get your plant to a level that is even higher than that, in health, in nutrition, in vitality, in vigor, then the plant has all it needs for its immune system to actually not be interesting to Japanese beetle. We need to start looking at why this plant has it, why that one doesn't have it, and try to give the plant everything it needs so that it can actually be immune to them, not attractive to them. You want to find out more about plant health that can repel insects? Check out this next video.